Coach Stig will make a statement, and then we'll open it up for some questions. Go ahead, Coach.
I'm really proud of our football team. They did a lot of things we asked them to do, and they did them pretty well against a really good Illinois State team. And the coolest thing, I think, is in the locker room, there wasn't the feeling, like so many times when you get a big win, that we've arrived. The feeling was kind of well done. It's kind of what we planned. Let's keep our focus on the goals, and that's a mature football team, and that falls on the shoulders of our seniors and our other captains, and I couldn't be more happy and more proud and more excited with that kind of attitude. So Coach Back and the Illinois State team, that's a good football team, and hats off to them, but it felt good to win that football game. Great crowd tonight. I don't care about numbers, but they were into the game, and they make a difference with the energy and the noise, so I appreciate the Jackrabbits that showed up for this last game in a really, really special place at South Dakota State University.
Question. John, your players didn't make it sound like you guys specifically talked this week about how important this win is as far as the top eight seeding and those things that you guys have talked about, but pretty clearly it was a pretty big game from that standpoint. Can you talk a little bit about just the ramifications of this win and how you guys sort of approached that?
Well, they approached it businesslike, and we took the approach not to talk about that so we didn't add pressure to them. And when you have a focused football team, those things are in your mind. And so they take care of themselves. And who knows what's said around the dinner table off campus housing or the dorm. I'm sure those things were talked about, but we as a coaching staff really kind of dumbed down our approach and said, this is what we need to do to win the football game, and not the ramifications of winning the football game, the result of winning the football game.
Is that because of the fact that you struggled in the North Dakota State game, lost the Northern Iowa game, that losing those home games affected how you approach this
one? Yeah. Well, who knows? You know, who knows? That was brought up by one of our coaches. And I'll leave it at that. All right? I like pressure. As an individual, when my boss says you need to do better, I like that. And not everybody's like that. And whatever recipe this was, we had the right recipe tonight. I tell you what, we can play better. We need to play better. If we want to get to where this program desires to be, we need to play better. But we're going to savor this victory.
Coach, up front, seeing the whole coverage in check, only 55 yards. Was it a matter of scheme or just winning the battle?
You can put two guys in the quarterback, but when you hand the ball off the running back, you can only afford to put one guy in every gap. So I would give credit to a simple design and unbelievable execution. He's a good football player. And so the D-line, the linebackers did their job in a simple scheme. So the quarterback, we did a pretty good job other than him scrambling. I did a pretty good job on him, too. So good job by Clint and his crew.
From an offensive standpoint, Zach started, but then once Taren had a couple good series, was it just riding a hot hand and keeping momentum? Is that why he stayed?
That's Eric's call. You know, I've been around coaches that tell me what to do as an assistant, and it's their job as a head coach. But I never felt comfortable in that situation because you work so hard. And so Eric made the call, and I supported him. And I mean, I changed one call in the game and it backfired, so that tells you, you know, what I should do as a head football coach. We were going to kick it deep at the end of the first half, you know, and I said squib it, so we kick an onside right to the doggone guy at the 10 yards away. So, and either way you slice it, that was that young man's first kick of his career, and I can't imagine what his heart rate was at that point. And, you know, they could have returned the kickoff for a touchdown, too. Who knows? But I got involved, and I shouldn't have.
Was Jay hurt today at some point?
Jay hurt, pulled a muscle.
Did that play into going for two a couple times?
Just the card. Our card dictated going for two. We take the call. We take the mindset out of that. You know, everybody reacts after you miss two and say, well, if you'd have went for one, hold the card, make the decision in 25 seconds, and we've already made those decisions. So the point differential said go for two both those times. I think it was 12 and 11 were the two times.
Is it safe to say that's Taren's best game so far?
I don't know that. You know, I'll watch the film. I tell you what Taren does that gets everybody excited. He buys more time. And, you know, was he great in terms of percentage? I don't think so. 15 for 30, that's not bad. Two interceptions, that's not good. He had a good game. So, yes.
I thought it was pretty good.
Yeah, okay. you want to write that? Yeah, it's a great game.
Yeah, I might go ahead and say it.
All right, good.
Okay.
Yeah, I make me sound smart.
Right.
Okay.
In a weird way, was it nice having both quarterbacks develop because Taren's helmet comes off, so Luan has to come in for a play?
That's the biggest play in a football game. That's the biggest play, and it's the biggest lesson for a player. We talk all the time about any play can win a football game. We put a quarterback in there that had been watching for however long. He throws a touchdown pass. Number one, he's got the poise to do that. Number two, you know, he's got the ability, the focus, all that stuff, and the maturity to not be hanging his head. I think it's unbelievable part of the game.
Anything more for Coach? All right, thanks, sir.
Super.